Well, mining is the backbone of the Zambian economy, particularly copper. It's famous for its copper and its exports around the world. Well, let's get a better sense now of what's happening in the mining sector in this country. And we are speaking to the Minister of Mines and Mineral Resources Development, and that's Minister Yaluma. Minister, thank you so much for chatting to us this
You're
morning.
Welcome.
Firstly, won't you give us an overview of what's happening in the mining sector in your country?
Well, firstly, we had a very, very bad patch over the past 2 years when you look at the mining, you know, history of Zambia. And you see, Zambia basically has been a mining country since maybe 1900s. And during this period, we've seen Zambia, you know, move from, you know, private, going to the 70s, it was privately owned, and then we nationalized over the late 70s into the 80s. And then around about 2000, 2001, again we said we'll let go into private hands. That's what we did. Reasons were mouthful, partly performance, and also just trying to ensure that we restructure, you know, transform the mining industry so that we can gain or get more revenue, you know, for the country. So we went that way. And since then, from 2001, it has been under private hands, and we've been performing well. We've seen the growth in production, you know, from, you know, coming close to where we ended. Because when we took over, it was hitting about 750,000 tons of copper. And then we took over, we saw it start shrinking. That's the poor performance I talked about. Until we got into almost close to 200, then we said, let's do something. So right now, as we speak, we are almost ranging about there, about 780,000 tons, despite, we could have gone beyond that if the copper price didn't just drop for the past 2 years.
What kind of reserves does Zambia have of copper and cobalt?
I'll tell you one thing. Zambia is mapped about 60%. And that varies from all the traditional mapping, drilling holes, you know, from the early times, okay? And up to now, 60 has been mapped. 40% we've gone out using the most modern technology. We are flying, you know, airborne surveys and all that, so that we can have that other part also, you know, ready for investment. But the old areas as well, because of using old technology, we have, you know, updated resources. So I can tell you that 40% which wasn't mapped is proving to be very, very lucrative and well endowed. The biggest mine right now, which was started from scratch, 2012, which is Kalumbila, is coming from the places which we had never thought that there was copper.
So the outside of the copper belt?
Outside the copper belt. The new copper belt, as I speak right now, is northwest. Northwestern province, it was never thought there would be mines springing up. So we've got three big mines in the area. We've got Kalumbila, owned by First Quantum. We've got Lumwana, owned by Barrick Gold. And Kansansha, again, owned by First Quantum. The traditional mining, the copper belt, is still going on. We still got investors. Glencore, for example, owns Mopani, which is Mufurira and Kitwe, and KCM owns Mchanga and Chilabombe, and Lubambe, which is, I presume, owned by Rainbow and the Brazilian mining company.
So you'd say Zambia is ripe for investment still in the mining sector?
That's an understatement. It is.
Yes.
I'll tell you one thing. Zambia today, I would say, is the most wanted you know, mining country to go and invest in. I'll tell you one thing. Like I said, we are very open to discussion with the investors. Zambia, today as it is, it has run elections, changed the governments without any drop of blood. Purely, as I sit here, I'm going to move out of this seat through a ballot. You know, and that is guaranteed. We all understand peace is essential in this game. If we want to grow our economy, we only remove governments through the ballot. If we don't perform as a government, yes, we'll be taken out. So we've got to ensure that we satisfy the expectation of the people of Zambia. So the people out there, they know we're politically stable. There is peace in Zambia. And what we give, what we offer, you know, we must review, because you see, investment coming, trickling into your country is highly competitive. Zimbabwe is wanting the same investment to trickle into their country. So is Mozambique, so is South Africa, so is Congo. So we've got to ensure that we fight for that. And to do that, we must relook at our policies, that our policies are sound, and the taxation regime we're going to give is something which will enlighten the people and elate them to come and invest here. I'll tell you one thing, an investor who stay in London or in South Africa, you'll be assured this mine is well ring-fenced and protected. You will sleep peacefully. You will come, you will wake up, how is it is perfect. We'll try to protect the investment of these foreign companies, because at the end of the day, if we don't do that, so is our economy. We also go down with them. So we've got to protect that.
Fantastic. Minister, thank you so much for your time.